get somebody to look that way. And so there's some neat things out there you can see, and there's a bit of wildlife out there. We have a bald eagle's nest on number 6 hole. And if you're lucky enough tonight, you'll see it perched over a big pine tree just at the number 7 tee off. And of course, the bald eagles are quite plentiful in Nova Scotia. We actually export them to the United States 5 times, trying to build your stock up. And but they do very well here because the farmers feed them through the winter. In this particular locale that we're at, we might have about 500 or more of them that come here just to run around. And it's quite a treat for us all to feed them in that number because they're everywhere. And, some of them used to nest where you can't come today, or else I can take breath in that area where they typically like to eat fish. But if we want to feed them, of course, the bird feeders make everybody want to hang around. Why would a park fly and all that way up there when you stay here? So we're getting quite a few of them to nest here now, and we're really fortunate this year to have a nest over here. And you won't see the nest, it's kind of a little low right now. But you might see the big bird flying around. And, last night I saw foxes here, and that was pretty exciting as well. And we get quite a few other different wildlife. And so it's a combination of walking around the park, checking out the wildlife, and just being up close to an apple orchard in some cases. A lot of people don't have an opportunity to see, and occasionally you'll be in the orchards, which is all right. You're going to knock a few apples off, but at least you have the opportunity to see a farm up close. And I think that's a more valuable lesson that we're giving away to people like you to come to see the farm, which are typically off limits today.